Just had the arrival of the Prime Minister, Honorable Roosevelt Skerritt. Thank you.
Thank you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. On the day of his baptism, Mark Valerian was welcomed into the church, given new life in Christ, and clothed with the garment of salvation. Today, we read the body of our brother, and surround him with the church's prayer. We commend our brother Mark Valerian to the mercy of God and pray that the promise made to him in baptism will be fulfilled.
Thank you.
that on the day of resurrection, free from the bonds of mortality, you may call me for your faith. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
prepared for you from the foundation of the world.
Anyone who comes to me, you will have
eternal life, and I will raise you up on the last day. So, as Christians, as believers, this is the firm assurance that we have. When our pilgrimage has come to an end on earth, we have, I would say, a life insurance for the other side. That is the best policy to have. I don't know, God, the premium of that insurance has been paid for us from the day that Jesus Christ came as our Redeemer and activated the plan of salvation that is that he planned for humanity, and the premium has been paid for us. And this is the joy that we have. And this is the great mystery that we celebrate today, the mystery of life beyond death. We're celebrating that, and we have the firm assurance that, listen, when we're dead on earth, when our pilgrimage on earth comes to an end, there is hope for the life beyond. In fact, the resurrection is the great mystery that gives us a sense of hope, because as a result of the mystery of the resurrection, death does not have the last word. It doesn't have the last word. So we cannot cry as people who don't have a sense of hope. The mission of the resurrection gives us that sense of hope that we will not, that is not the end of us when we die then. I like to tell people that, you know, because for some of us, it's so much better in Creole when we speak the Creole. There's a little more of path in the back. So one of the virtues I would say, we're not present there because there is something that none of us cannot familiarize ourselves with. Listen, you may know that somebody is going to die for some reason, you know, but we still have a sense of hope. And we still, you know, when that day comes, and then we always frighten us. Because it is that something unknown to us. What's going to happen to us? Where are we going to? These are some basic anthropological questions that we ask ourselves. Where are we going to? Where we come from? Where we are going to? Where is our destination? But I have to give you a reminder of the fact that as believers, for some of us, some of us deliberately say, well, there is no God. There is no, you know, what Christianity is doing about talking about this, come from this particular parish. But also, there is a subculture that all of us have to fight against it. It is a culture of, you know, division and create and make life a living hell for other people. This is a subculture that we have to get rid of. We are not going anywhere in this generation unless we attack the root of this wound from the very foundation of it. This is a very difficult subculture to deal. It has tremendous that some good people in this community, but at the end of the day, some attitude, some approach, this is non-Christianity. And it is not the Christian value that we have received from the very beginning. I always tell people that those things, wickedness, trying to destroy the life of others, it is not a high master. Whether you are Catholic Christians, whether you are Adventist, you are Jehovah's Witness, whatever you are, if you form this particular community and all those who are outside, that subculture we have of destruction, that culture of death and backbiting and destruction, it is not the best way to go. But deep within them, they become like the slave of sin, an agent of destruction. So why is that? Why is it so? Listen, you know bad news very quickly about somebody. That way, you don't have to go on social media to spread the bad news about somebody. But when you come to good, to say good about somebody, at least, you know, to identify something good about the life of someone, because all of us are created. God give us that opportunity to make an impact on the life of somebody. And our brother, you know, one of the few last things that he did when before he died, he said, he instructed one of the family members to go and kill a goat and to give food to everybody. You know what is what it means? It is something that he wants to leave. moment of his departure. I was asking the young children in the history of day, what can you remember about Uncle Siku? Well, some of them said to me, they told me, there is a song that he liked to sing. And they start singing this song. Micah and Tyler, they start singing this song. So therefore, you see, the man has come, he came into being. God created him in his own image and likeness. He has a purpose. He has an objective in life, something to fulfill. And he come, he fulfill his purpose, and make the impact that he's supposed to have, and he move on into life. That is all it is. All of us, we come into being, we come into this life to fulfill that purpose that God placed in us, and then to move on into the next stage of life. Listen, this is the next stage of life. Or rather, we reach to the living, you don't reach to the dead. We use the example of the life of our father to remind you of one day your turn also will come. And if your opportunity, the opportunity to go right now, it is not an opportunity. It is if you are not by school right now, the question you have to ask yourself, what is the life you have to look like for me? And it is, you have to know that very well. The life you live on earth, it has a constant relationship with the life beyond. If the life you live on earth, I was saying that the other day, you cannot believe in your life as a man feeling, and then expect to have a life of a Cicero Award when you reach another. But when you fall inside, more afraid of the corona than anything else. A little boy is who I went to see his grandmother. The grandmother went to the hospital because she was not feeling well. When she came back, the little boy refused to go close to Granny. You know why? He thought they took Granny to the hospital because Granny has corona. And they gave him something to carry for Granny. He put it on the table and he ran. He said, Granny, they put something there for you without saying you. So we concern so much about our physical body. But what about our soul? Where that soul going to? If our number is called at this moment as we're talking now. So we don't know the time, we don't know the moment, we don't know at what moment our number will be called. The only thing I can tell you know what it is? Make the necessary preparation. Because if everything goes wrong while living on earth, listen, when you go beyond, you're living too much on the account of the Holy Spirit. Do the work now and do so much for the Holy Spirit to do for you.
Yeah.
Because when you reach over there, you are no longer responsible for yourself. Mm. It's those fellow Christians living behind that can pray for your soul because the soul continues the journey towards the Father. And then what? When you reach up there, they say, you are not qualified. Just live your life in a way that it is a testimony for the life of others. You'll be a witness to the risen Christ in your own life. But as it says, as we're talking now, it may sound like, you know, theological thoughts, things that don't make any sense to human beings. But there's a deep spiritual meaning in the life we live in. You are not a mere biological function on the face of the earth. You are more than that. You are also a spiritual being. You know, there is something about your soul that you have to do on account of the life you have been living on earth. Why is it you concentrate on anything else except of the most important part of who you are? Concentrate and work on your soul, work on yourself, because the journey, the time will come when your journey on earth will come to an end. And when you come to an end, what about the rest of the journey? Are you going to sit down to see whether I can continue? It is not like that. You have to go. And when your number is called, you have to go. And there is no better thing I can tell you to them. And to really ask the person who tells us, the soul of the just are in the hands of God. You know, the soul of the just. Me and you, we cannot determine who is to be saved or not. Who's qualified or not. We cannot say that. If we could say that, if we can do that, we could determine that. Listen, I will take all my family members, make sure all of them go into heaven. But at the end of the day, you cannot do that. Those things are not up to you. You are not given that responsibility. The best thing to do is to live and let live. I say live and let live because some of us, sometimes we make life a living hell for others. It is not the purpose of our life to make life a living hell for others. You think that is the case? That is not the case. And as the gospel reminds us, when at the end of time, the eschaton, the judgment call, God will put the goat and the sheep on one and on both sides, on the right hand side, the sheep, and the right hand side, the goat. So, would you like to be a goat or would you like to be a sheep? So, it's up to you for now to determine, for now to decide where you want to be. If you want to be on the left hand side, you know your business already. Organize your business. And now, when the moment comes and you don't know what to do, what to say again, and God will be the one to make the final decision. And I cannot tell you what you will decide. And if we have 24 hours to live, some of us will do all kinds of things. We will jump high and jump low, parties, go do this, do that, but some of us will lose, we'll miss it, or we'll defeat the purpose of living the life on earth. The time is difficult. We live in at a moment where there is a right to a culture of death surrounding us. Death is easy. Now, in the past, people used to think that only when somebody is advanced in age, you could die easily, you die quickly. No, death attacks any single one. There is no, I would say, discrimination. I'm taking this and I'm not going to take that now. Death is even the youngest one. As you see, young people are those who are dying faster. Old people are those burying their young people. Why is that so? So, we have to think about that. God is speaking, there's a theological lesson behind that. God is speaking to us. Let us make the necessary preparation. Because I don't know the time, I don't know the moment. If I had known the moment, I would have come and tell each one of us, listen, it is tomorrow. Get ready and go and pack your bag. But I don't know the moment, I don't know the time. The only thing I can tell you, again and again, I deliver the message and I wash my hand like consciousness.
Oh,
be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
Lift your heart to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For as one alone he accepted death, so that we might all escape from dying. As one man he chose to die, so that in your sight we all might live forever. And so, in company of the poets of angels, we praise you, and with joy we proclaim.
Thank you.
the mystery of faith.
Thank you.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter my room. But only say, Lord, that my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ be for sin for eternal life.
Amen. Thank you.
this song is a special request from Mary, Siko's niece, who couldn't be here with us today. So we do this on her behalf.
After giving it my all.
rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessing which you bestowed upon Mark Valerie in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn to us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our brother forever and ever.
Amen.
May the angels lead you into paradise. May the martyrs come to welcome you and take you to the holy city, the new and eternal Jerusalem. In peace, let us take our brother to his place of rest.
So there you have it, the funeral of Mark Valerie. They're going to not sicko. Join me shortly at the burial ground. I'm going to end the stream right now. Have a good afternoon. Yes! Cemetery for the burial of Manasco. The hearse is still at the back. Thank you. God.
I know.
This is the new health center being constructed at Bilkas.
Power in the blood of the Lamb.
Please bear with me as I'm going down the hill.
Brother Mark Valerie has gone to his rest in the peace of Christ. May the Lord now welcome him to the table of God's children in heaven. With faith and hope and eternal life, let us assist him with our prayers. Let us pray to the Lord also for ourselves. May we, who mourn, be reunited one day with our brother. Together, may we meet Christ Jesus when he who is our life appears in glory. Read in scripture. This is the will of my Father, says the Lord, that I should lose nothing of all that he has given to me, and that I should raise it up on the last day. O God, by whose mercy the faithful departed find rest, bless this grave and send your holy angel to watch over it, as we bury here the body of our brother. Deliver his soul from the bonds of sin, that he may rejoice in you with your saints forever. Because God has chosen to call our brother Mark Valerie from this life to himself, we commit his body to the earth, for we are dust, and unto dust we shall return. But the Lord Jesus Christ will change our mortal bodies to be like his in glory, for he is risen the firstborn from the dead. So let us commend our brother to the Lord, that the Lord may embrace him in peace and raise his body on the last day. Our response is, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
For our brother, Mark Valerie, let us pray to our Lord Jesus Christ,
who said, I am the resurrection and the life. Whoever believes in me shall live even in death, and whoever lives and believes in me shall never die. We pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. Lord, you console Martha and Mary in their distress. Draw near to us. We mourn for our brother Valerie. Enjoy the tears of those who weep. We pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. You wept at the grave of Lazarus, your friend. Comfort us in our sorrow. We pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. You raised the dead to life. Give to our brother eternal life. We pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. You promised paradise to the repentant thief. Bring Mark Valerie to the joys of heaven. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Our brother was washed in baptism and anointing with the Holy Spirit. Give him the fellowship with all your saints. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
He was nourished with your body and blood. Grant him a place of rest at the table of your heavenly banquet. We pray to the Lord. God of holiness and power, accept our prayers on behalf of your servant Mark. Do not count on his deeds against him. For in his heart, he desired to do your will. As his faith united him to your people on earth, so may your mercy join him to the angels in heaven. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Merciful Lord, you know the anguish of the sorrowful. You are attentive to the prayers of the humble. Hear your people who cry to you in their need, and strengthen their hope in your lasting goodness. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon him. May his soul and the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen. May the peace of God, which is beyond all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of Christ and of his Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Family members.
Thank you.
Everybody, brothers and sisters, well, I would like to say something on the behalf of the deaf. He was my sister child uncle, but I don't know if all the family know her, but his brother Bernard was my sister child uncle, and he was a friend to me. So I can say, God help him and put him in your hands, in the hands of Lord. Amen.
Thank you.
Amen.
Amen.
that's in. I mean, Siko was my good friend. I'm feeling very sorry to see we burying him today. It's very sad. Very, very sad.
Good afternoon. Good afternoon, everyone. I am the supervisor for NEP for the North, and on behalf of the director, Mrs. Honore, and the staff of the National Employment Program, we would like to extend deepest sympathy to the Bibi family. Mark, as we know, was an NEP worker and the supervisor, who is Agatha. We want to extend on behalf of the NEP family God's blessings and wish them all the best in this time of need.
Thank you very much. So now we're having some tributes on behalf of Siko.
Hi, Emo, good afternoon. Mr. Mark Valerie was employed at the Baroness Patricia Scotland as the groundsman, but he was more than a groundsman. He was a security officer, he was a messenger, he was even a doctor. You know, we at Baroness Primary, we will miss him a lot because we had established a very good relationship. He has established a good relationship with the staff, the students, and ancillary staff. And his death really came as a shock to us all. And we are really going to miss him, but he will definitely cherish the moments, the good moments that we had together. May his soul rest in peace.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Nana's been rather reckless and free.
On far afar, he longs to settle down beside a stream flowing through eternity. Like a grass on the lawn,
he will pass by the way and be gone. A lesson
to learn, we walk but once in glory. And for it, let my wonder.
once again, this is Emma News. Thank you for viewing. Thank you all for spending the afternoon with me. It's a pleasure doing this for the family. As always, my broadcast is compliments to family and the Flow Dominica, my service provider of choice. The family of the late Mark Valerie would like to extend our sincere gratitude and to those who extended a helping hand during his illness and time of bereavement. Your kind words and support were truly appreciated. May he rest in peace. This is Emma News, broadcasting live from Vilcas.
No, it's. They never like you neither. I suppose.